Thank you, sir, for allowing me to speak on this Trafficking of Persons Bill 2018. Sir, as we speak, it's very sad. Every 8 minutes, a child in this country goes missing. And every year, thousands of women, children, transgenders, men are being trafficked into slavery, forced labor, and prostitution on a daily basis. And South Asia, with India at its center, is the fastest growing and the second largest region for human trafficking after East Asia, according to UN Office of Drugs and Crime. And sir, the US State Department had placed us as a tier 2 country in its annual report of 2018. Because of the conviction rates, investigations, prosecutions in this country are disproportionately low relative to the scale of human trafficking. And it's unfortunate, sir, this government has been very, very silent on 1,11,569 children missing in the 2016 year alone. And out of these 1,11,569 children, only 55,944 children were recovered. And rest of the children, we have no data, and the government has never been vocal about this. I request the Honorable Minister to be very empathetic to the situation and revert on that. And at this time, sir, and these situations in the country, I truly welcome this bill. Sir, I support this bill on behalf of my party, TRS, for four reasons mainly. One, in our country, we never had a proper framework to prevent trafficking, and we did not have a proper legal framework for protection of victims and witnesses, and we did not have a framework or a time-bound way to prosecute the offenders, and we did not also have a time-bound rehabilitation and repatriation of victims. And this bill promises to provide all the four. Particularly when we speak about prevention of trafficking in person, this really goes in concurrence with Honorable Prime Minister's idea, where he has identified 115 districts and is trying to develop the most distressed districts of the nation. So this, particularly by formulating capacity building programs, can certainly empower the vulnerable population, and we can prevent the trafficking to a great extent. So I certainly welcome this move. And of course, when it comes to the protection of victims, this has never been the interest in various laws which we have. Our learned friend Shashi Tharoorji was stating, and many other members have said, we do already have certain laws which speak about the provisions of the same bill, but they do not speak about the victims or protection of the victims as this bill does. And this bill, sir, proposes to establish a national anti-trafficking bureau, which is a very, very welcome move. And this national anti-trafficking bureau is not only at the national level, but at the state level, district level also will have its offices and network that can interact with the people directly, vulnerable sections directly. So this again is a very welcome move, sir. And the best part of this protection is the identity of the victims and the identity of the witnesses will be protected with the help of the local police and officers. And of course, prosecution of the offenders. All of us know, sir, in India, we have a law for each and every crime. We have a law, we have laws for the most heinous crimes also. But kyun darte nahi ye log is desh mein kisi crime commit karne se pehle? Because they are never brought to justice. And in the courts, the cases are stuck for years and years, and before justice is rendered, sir, it is too late. And the best part of this bill, and I truly appreciate Honorable Minister's effort in this, adding this clause in the bill, ma'am, just within 1 year, they would be brought to justice, sir. And for this purpose, a designated courts are given in each and every district, and also special public prosecutors will be also chosen for to make sure that this process go in very well, sir. And another very interesting and important part and the sensitive side of this government is revealed when you have allowed, ma'am, to provide for in-camera trial and via video conferencing trial. Usually victims and witnesses have a very sensitive kind of a situation where they can't personally be attending the court, and allowing this trial is a true path-breaking scenario in this bill. And of course, when it comes to rehabilitation, many of the members have said it is again an approach of taking the victims when you rescue them and putting them in the state homes. But what else can a government do, and how else can it work? But to a greater extent, this bill also tries to address that issue by involving various communities and NGOs. This is a first step, sir. So I believe we all should give this government, this bill a chance. We should support it. Meanwhile, ma'am, I do have certain suggestions to make. My sincere suggestion, ma'am, number one, Union Home Ministry has already done a great deal of job, and they do run a separate website to control this human trafficking. And they have set up anti-human trafficking units in almost 264 districts of this country. And Rajnath Singh ji is planning to increase the number to 332. So there should be a synergy, ma'am, between the Women and Child Development Ministry and the Home Ministry. Since the house is already set up, the units are already set up, we don't need to spend again more money and, you know, and then another initiative by your honorable self, ma'am, you had also set up short stay homes and Swadhar homes across the nation, and about 50 crores is the budget, sir, in this year given to these Swadhar homes. So these Swadhar homes can also be utilized as a part of this bill, ma'am. And another one issue which truly disappointed most of the people in this nation regarding this bill, sir, this is a very organized crime. If you have to traffic one lady and they lay eyes on one girl, this mafia, sir, waits for 6 to 8 months to make sure that the girl is convinced that this boy is going to marry her. They marry her and send her across. So this is a very organized crime. So our response as a government also should be, ma'am, very, very organized. That means we have to go to the root of the issue. And ma'am, I have been really disappointed because when we look at the figures today in this country, majority of the trafficked people are going and they're sent to these forceful labor and laborious jobs. And number two, they're being sent to the prostitution houses. So the number one area where we are sending them, this bill and your ministry, ma'am, apparently has never interacted with any labor organizations, and the ministry has apparently never interacted with the industry properly. So I believe at least during forming the rules, ma'am, for this bill, kindly interact with the labor organizations, because as Satpathy ji was saying, and even in Hyderabad, my city of Hyderabad, we see a major influx of labor from various neighboring states, ma'am, Andhra Pradesh and Maharashtra. So once these labor come in, they don't come in forcefully. They do want to come in willfully. So kindly look into that issue, ma'am. And another one issue I want to draw your attention, ma'am. In our country, whichever crime happens, either it's drug trafficking or human trafficking, many a times foreign nationals are involved. And this bill does not talk about a foreign national. So my sincere request to you, ma'am, please look into a scenario where a foreign national gets himself into this kind of a crime. How do we address this? Okay. Address that this is not. And last one, just one last point, sir. Page number 14, ma'am, in this bill, which speaks about offences and penalties, clause number 31 and 11th. This says, ma'am, by encouraging or abetting any person to migrate illegally into India or Indians into some other country. Ma'am, this is a very draconian provision, ma'am. I sincerely urge you to kindly look into it and get it removed. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Sorry, Mohammad.